February 12, 1981. Active duty, Air National Guard, and Air Force Reserve men and women begin deployment for a Southern Command exercise to test the defense of the Panama Canal. It's called Blackhawk Four. Military Airlift Command air crews fly 60 sorties. They carry more than 1,000 troops and 700 tons of equipment for the start of the exercise. It's the total force in action. In the early 1900s, the U.S. recognized the strategic importance of Panama. The Hay-Herran Treaty gave the U.S. the right to construct a canal and control it for 100 years. A 1977 treaty provided for combined defense of the canal by U.S. and Panamanian forces. The U.S. holds primary responsibility for defense of the area till the year 2000, when the treaty expires. That's why there is an annual exercise like Blackhawk Four. It gives our people the kind of realistic training they need to meet that responsibility. Simulated night bombing missions and guerrilla activities keep the exercise true to life, while intensive jungle operations familiarize the troops with Panama's rugged terrain and climate. Its realism sharpens skills needed to fight in and over jungle terrain anywhere in the world.
This Blackhawk exercise here in Panama exposes our new troops to air defense, and it trains them to react quickly to any air-to-ground attacks.
On my civilian job, I handle a lot of fine and intricate jewelry. But for the Air National Guard, I load these practice bombs and the real ones, and I love it.
An exercise of this scope takes teamwork. Air crew members, along with maintenance, ground troops, aggressors, and friendly forces, work day and night in a successful test of combat readiness. Black Hawk 4 put it all together, the total force policy at work.